गुड मॉर्निंग अक्षय, गुड मॉर्निंग राहुल, गुड मॉर्निंग चंद्रशेखर। गुड मॉर्निंग आदेश, गुड मॉर्निंग सिद्धेश। गुड मॉर्निंग राहुल, गुड मॉर्निंग आर्यन, गुड मॉर्निंग कुणाल, गुड मॉर्निंग श्रेयस। Okay, let's recap what we have considered in yesterday's session. So we were going through the Vedic literature, right? So we have considered four different Vedic literatures as Vedas, Brahmins, the Aryankas, and the Upanishads. So in this, we have again considered that the Vedic literature grown up and handed over by generation to generation by the word of mouth, that is Shrut, right? So it's called Shrut, right? So among all these, the Vedas are the most important, which are considered. So they are also called as the Apar Shreya, that means not created by man but by God gifted. And another word or terminology is Nitya, which is existing in all eternity. It was existing yesterday, it will be exist today, it will also exist tomorrow. So eternity, right? Anandaka. So there are four Vedas: Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, and Atharveda. Right? Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, and Atharveda. So jointly, first three, Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda, are called Veda 3, which is also called as Trio of Vedas. So as far as Rig Veda is concerned, it is nothing but the collection of the lyrics, right, which is oldest text in the world. Therefore, it is known as the first testament of mankind, you can consider it. Then Yajurveda, it's a book of sacrificial prayers. So it's a ritual Veda. Samaveda is a book of chants, and Atharveda is a book of magical formulas to ward off evils and diseases, to keep away the evils and diseases. That is the case. So this is first kind, or the first category of the Vedic culture. Second category, we can consider Brahmins. So Brahmanas explains the hymens of the Vedas. It's what are the hymens in the Vedas. In fact, it is called Richas. जसं आपण गीतेतले श्लोक म्हणतो तसे वेदांत वेदामध्ये रिचा म्हणतात, राईट? बट बाय अँड लार्ज द सेम वर्ड इन इंग्लिश, हायमेन्स. ठीक आहे, आपल्या अंडरस्टँडिंगसाठी श्लोक. सो ब्राह्मणस रिटन इन प्रोस अँड रिच्युअलिस्टिक इन नेचर. सो गद्य भाग आहे, रिच्युअलिस्टिक इन नेचर आहे, रटाळवण असू शकतं. सो ब्राह्मण मीन्स सॅक्रिफाईस, अँड ब्राह्मणस डिस्कसिंग ऑर डिस्कस्ड व्हेरियस sacrifices and rituals. So each Veda contains several Brahmanas. So as far as Rig Veda is concerned, it consists Aitreya and Kaushitki. Yajurveda consists the Shatpath and Taittiriya. Samaveda consists the Panchavisha, Shadvinsh, Changodya, Chandogya, and Jaiminiya. And Atharvaveda contain only one, that is Gopatha. Right. So now third one is Aryankas. So Aranyakas, that is Aranya means the forest. So Aranyakas written mainly for the hermits and the students living in jungle, right? Vidyarthi yani sadhu. Aranyakas is concluding portion of the Brahmanas. Later on comes in the fourth category, That is Upanishadas. So Upanishadas is nothing but the philosophical text which you can consider. So it discusses the meditation and the spiritual knowledge, generally called as Vedanta, right? Ant, Vedanta, Shevaka. Then the literature of Vedic tradition.
Literature of Vedic tradition
over the period from 600 BC to 600 AD. Right? So it comprises six literary works. It comprises six literary works. So very first one is Vedangas, which can also be termed as Sutras. So here you can have Siksha, Vakrana, Nikruta, Kalpa Sutra, then Chanda and Jyotisha. Then you have Smriti. So as far as Smriti are concerned, you do have Manusmriti, Yajnavalkya Smriti, Narad Smriti, Parashara Smriti, Brihaspati Smriti, and Katayana Smriti. Fine. Then Mahakavyas, so epics. Two epics you do have: Ramayana, written by Valmiki, Mahabharata by Vedvyas. Puranas, right? So there are 18 different Purans you can consider, right? So next one is Upavedas. So in Upavedas, you will be having the Vedas corresponding, Upavedas. Vedas corresponding to Upavedas. Upavedas corresponding to Vedas. So there are four different Upavedas you can have. Ayurveda, and it is associated with Rigveda. Then Gandharvaveda, which is of music. It's about, or it is corresponding to Samved. Then Dhanurved, it is of archery. It's a corresponding or associated with the Yajurveda. And Shilpaved, which is also called as Arthaved. It is a science of craft and wealth, so associated with the Atharved. And then Shad Darshana. So there are six different schools of Indian philosophy, right, in which first we have considered Sankhya Darshan. Kapila is founded by Kapila, and it is having a text called Sankhya Sutra. Yoga Darshana, established by Patanjali, right? Its texts are Yoga Sutra. Nyay Darshan, Gautam Ashpak, Akshapada, right? Gautam Akshapada was the founder of Nyay Darshan, and its text is Nyay Sutra. And I think we have reached to the fourth one, right? Which is called Vaisheshika Darshan, right? So that is what you can consider about the fine. So the next one you will be considering. So as I said, you can consider the next one. Fine. So Vaisheshika Darshan, it was founded by Oluka, Kannada. Oluka, Kannada. Right. And its basic text is the Vaisheshika Sutra. Vaisheshika Sutra. The fifth one, your Mimamsa, or Purva Mimamsa, you can consider. So Mimamsa, right, which was established or founded by Jaimini, founded by Jaimini. And here you can have its text as Purva Mimamsa Sutra. And the next one is Vedant, or which is called Uttar Mimamsa. Right. So, right here I can consider Purva Mimamsa Vedant. Here I can consider Uttar Mimamsa. So Vedant was founded by Badrayana, right? And its basic text is Brahma Sutra. Basic text is Brahma Sutra. Right. So this is what you can consider about the literature, which is termed as the literature of Vedic tradition. Fine. So these are the some of the things you will be always considering. Now, see, we have considered the Vedic culture. In fact, we are in the Vedic culture, right, or the Vedic period. So in that case, we have considered origin of the Aryans, right, or origin of the homeland of Aryans. We have considered Vedic literature, right, and associated with that was the part. Therefore, we have considered the literature having the tradition of Vedic literature. But now in Vedic culture, we have to consider, after its literature, its geography. We have to also look into polity. We have to consider society, and we have to consider the religion of Vedic culture, and obviously we have to consider its economy. So these are the different points which we can consider. So let's consider the geographical area. Geographical area. See, if you want to start anything new, so you will be always considering right from the geographical things, right? So this is the way you can consider. So geographical area. As far as the Rig Veda is the right is the only source for this kind of source of knowledge for this particular period. So whatever Rig Veda is containing, so that we can contain as that we can consider as the geographical area. Suppose Rig Veda is mentioning the rivers, mountains, and the ocean. So we have to believe that, yes, because whatever we are considering, so as far as ancient India is concerned, so it's the first testament, right, or whatever we do have, right? So whatever Rig Veda, so it is the belief. See, if someone is having the confusion that, or someone is thinking that whether I should believe in Rig Veda or not, right? I will tell you, if all the corners of India are believing on a common theme, and which is called Rig Veda, then why we should not believe on it, whether it is true or not? Right? Keep it away. But if every corner is believing in it, if every corner is having the references of the things which are mentioned in this particular, let's say, literature called Rig Veda, right? And basically, Rig Veda is the first one you can consider, right? So that is the reason why we have considered it, right? Why I have told you that Rig Veda is composed when the people, or when the civilization was in the Punjab. That means from where they have started, right? So as far as our civilization is concerned, fine. So as far as the geographical areas, locations, right? So exactly this was the location. So the source of knowledge, right, or the source of references or evidences would be the Rig Veda. So whatever Rig Veda is mentioning, that you can consider the geographical area. Fine. So Rig Veda is the only source of knowledge of this period. So from the names of rivers, mountains, and ocean, right? So there will be seven different rivers you can consider, right, where the people have settled down. Not only seven rivers, there might be some other rivers which might be in the Rig Veda. I think around 40 names of rivers are there in Rig Veda. As far as mountains are concerned, you can have the Himavant, which is nothing but Himalaya, and the Munjavanth, which is nothing but the Hindu Kush. Right? So Himavant and Himalaya and Hindu Kush. So two mountains, you can have 40 different rivers, you can have, right? And in this case, again, you will be having the names of ocean. Right? So this is what we can have in Rig Veda. Right? So Rig Veda is having a clear idea of geographical area, right, which is wherein the Rigvedic people must have lived, right? So this is the case you will be always considering. So there is a hymen in the Rigveda called Nadisukta, right? So Nadisukta hymen of the Rigveda mentioning 21 different rivers, which are including even Ganga in the east and the Kubha, that is Kabul, in the west. So Rigvedic people who had called themselves Aryans were confirmed in the area which came to be known as Sapt Sindhu. Right? So Aryans used to call the place where they are living is Sapt Sindhu, which is nothing but the land of seven different rivers, Sapt Sindhu. So Sapt Sindhu comprises of Sindhu, right? You know that particular name. Right. So whatever name I will be telling were the names in Rig Veda or Rig Vedic names. No doubt you do have the modern names of these. So Sindhu, right? And some other rivers you can have Vitastra, Asikani, Vipas, Parushani, Sutudri, and Saraswati. So these are the seven different rivers. Right. So if you consider their region, so all these were in Punjab except Saraswati, which is in Rajasthan. Fine. So you can consider. So what are their modern names? So Sindhu is Indus, Vitastha is Jhelum, Asikani is Chinav, Vipas is Bias, Parushani is Ravi, and Sutudri is Satluj, whereas Saraswati is Saraswati. Right. So these are the different names. Right. You can have Rigvedic names, you can have modern names. Along with the names, you will be always having their region, where in which region they are. Right? So that is the case you will be always considering. So as far as geographical area is concerned, right? So the Rig Veda was the only source of knowledge of this period. So, right, Rig Veda is giving clear idea of geographical area. Right? Therefore, Rig Veda, right, or what I can consider names in Rig Veda, right, giving clear idea of the geographical area, right, in which the Rig Vedic people must have lived. So what these names were? So these names will be of three kinds. You can have rivers, ocean, and the mountains. Right. So rivers, ocean, and mountains. So these three names you can always consider. So Rig Veda is mentioning the rivers. Fine. Around 40 rivers. Right. You can consider. Don't worry about the numbers. Fine. And there is a hymen called Nadisukta hymen. Right. So Nadisukta hymen. Nadisukta hymen, which is mentioning the 21 rivers, right, which includes, right. So mention rivers, right, including Ganga, right, you can call it as Ganges, and Kubha, which is nothing but Kabul. This is at east and this is at west. Fine. So as I said, yes. So I'm going to tell, right, that among these names, only 7 are what we can consider having concern with this particular point. So we will be just considering 7 names, right? So that is called Sapta Sindhu. So you know, Rigvedic people who were called Aryans, right? So Aryans confirmed in the area which came to know, right? So Aryans confirmed in area called Sapta Sindhu, right? That is 7 rivers, 7 rivers, right? So what were these 7 rivers? You can consider. If anybody wants, you can have this one. Otherwise, I will go to the next page where I will be writing all the names of rivers in the Rigvedic name and its modern name. Done. So what are these 7 different names, right, or 7 different rivers? So here you can have Sindhu, second you can have Vitasta, you can have Asikani, you can have Vipass, you can have Parushani, you can have Sutudri, yes, Rigvedic names, Sutudri and Saraswati. Right. So these were the Rigvedic names. Now, what are their modern names? Right. So modern names, Sindhu is nothing but Indus. Vitasta is nothing but Jhelum. Asikani is nothing but Chinav. Vipass is nothing but Bias. Parushani is nothing but Ravi. Sutudri is nothing but Satluj. Sutudri is nothing but Satluj. And Saraswati is nothing but Saraswati. Right. Saraswati. So among these first 6 are in Punjab. Punjab region, and this is in Rajasthan region. This is in Rajasthan region. Right. So what you can always consider. Right. So this is the region called Sapta Sindhu, right, region. So, you know, as I said, whatever mentioned in the Rig Veda would be the what we will be considering as the source of this particular information. So Rig Veda is mentioning most of the times the river Sindhu, right? Rig Veda is mentioning the most pious river, pious, pavitra, right? Dharmic, Saraswati. Rig Veda is also mentioning the Ganga, right? The Rigveda is also mentioning the Yamuna, right? Particularly Ganga is mentioned only one time, Yamuna is mentioned 3 times, Sindhu is mentioned several times, or the most mentioned is the Sindhu, and the most pious, is Saraswati. So this is what you can always consider, right? Fine. See, these are the things which we can always look as relevant, right? So it is, these are not the ultimate truths or the facts, because if you today go on finding something new, you may get something new, so you will be added up, right? So that will be get added up in that particular way. Fine. So this is one thing. Again, Rig Veda is also mentioning a war, the battle of 10 kings called Dasarajan War. Right. So Rig Veda is not only telling about the geographical area, but it is also telling you about Dasarajan War. Obviously, it will be related to, yes, Sid. It will be always related to geographical area. So Dasarajan War, that is also called as the battle of 10 kings. Right. So Rig Veda mentions the Dasarajan War. Dasarajan War. Right. So that is the battle of 10 kings. Battle of 10 kings. Right. So Dasarajan War. So no doubt it will be giving you the names of 10 different kings who were participated in the war against Sudas. So this was against Sudas, right? So Sudas was the king of Tritsas family, and so Bhata king of, who was Sudas? Sudas, right? What I was, okay, it was Bharata king of Tritsas family. Tritsas family, right? So you can always consider these things. Fine. So this particular war was fought on the bank of Ravi, that is Parushani, right? So fought on bank of Ravi, bank of Ravi, and in which the Sudas emerged as victorious. Sudas emerged as victorious. So is anybody there who is interested in the 10 names of the kings? In other words, do you want all the names? Okay. Fine. So what these 10 kings, right? Who were these? Fine. So this will be a thing. As far as the exam is concerned, right, Dasarajan War was against whom? This would be one question. Who was emerged as victorious? That can be second. And third one is who fought on which bank of river? That would be the questions you can consider always. Fine. So anyway, it will take a minute. We will just go through. So first you can consider the Purus, right? Second, you can consider Yadus, Purus, Yadus. Third one is Turvasas. Fourth one is Anus. And fifth one you can consider Dhruvayus. Dhruvayus.